What does it mean to have this film shown at the London Film Festival?
It's massive for me. You know, I've basically spent the last 15 years here in London, and the first week I turned up, I came to the London Film Festival when I was just a student, and it's always been a bit of a dream of mine to actually bring a film here. So I'm immensely grateful to Claire Stewart and the team for inviting us this year.
And for those who are looking forward to seeing the movie, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, Spike Island is a film about five kids growing up in Manchester in 1990, and their heroes are the Stone Roses, and the Stone Roses are about to play their biggest gig ever, which is Spike Island. But these kids can't get tickets, they don't know how to get there, they don't know how they're going to get in. So it basically almost turns into kind of like a Ocean's 11, like a heist film. How are they going to get past the security? How are they going to get over the fence? Are they going to dig a tunnel? How are they going to blag their way in? And along the way, they're in a band and they want to hand over a demo tape to the band. So they spend a lot of time kind of falling in and out of love. One of their parents is ill. They fall out with each other along the way and they go on a bit of an adventure.
Well, you mentioned in the background there are some very serious issues. How do you think the marriage between the two works? How did you handle that?
There's some serious stuff to it, and that's what I liked about Chris's script. You know, for me, I think if it was all upbeat and happy and buzzy, then actually it wouldn't have any weight to it. And what I liked was that the character has to kind of tussle with, you know, no one's perfect. The main character has to kind of tussle with staying and like looking after his dad and his family, or going off and having the time of his life. And, you know, I think actually most people had been in a situation, maybe not as pronounced as that, but it suddenly made the whole film bittersweet. You know, the kids don't all stay friends. They don't all achieve their dreams. And that for me made it a bit more real.
In terms of the music, what is it about the Stone Roses that makes them so significant for the past 20 years?
Stone Roses are just the best band in the world. It's amazing, isn't it? There was something about them. I remember growing up, I grew up a little bit, I was too young to see them the first time around, and yet you couldn't be into music and not love their albums. You couldn't not be a passionate about music and be a bit of a Stone Roses obsessive. And I never thought I'd get a chance to see them. The cast and crew all went to go and see them at Heaton Park. But I think, you only have to listen to a couple of notes of the first album and you get it exactly, like straight away.